Guys, I'm going to start you out with just a little floating drill. Spiral ride. One thing I want you to realize, a spiral ride, all spiral means is circular. So a lot of coaches teach that spiral ride is going to forward and come inside and by. Spiral to circular. Yes, it's spiral motion. If I'm going to spiral ride a guy to get a one-on-one grip, I'm going to spiral ride and roll. If I want to set up a half Nelson from the knees, then I want to spiral ride him back at an angle. So I'm going to look at his body like a clock. That's 12 and 4 to 6, 3 and 9. And what I'm going to do, since I'm going to put a hammer on my right arm, I'm going to use the clock technique of putting my hand on the elbow inside his thigh. My elbow is the key to his head. So then I'm going to use my hand inside his thigh. Then I'm going to jump to the opposite side and pull back at 4:30, right to here, to his butt. And his natural reaction is going to be to get back to his base. Guys? And my job, as it gets back up, is to stuff the head under the armpit, get this hack on nice and tight, underneath the armpit, nice and tight on the neck. Now, a lot of coaches say get at the elbow because you get a lot more power or calm the head. No. Underneath the armpit, nice and tight, nice and low on the neck. And once you get the hack down, I want you to turn your wrist down like a karate chop. Right? But, actually, before we start that, all we're going to do is a little spiral drill, and this hack can get back to your base. Spiral right into his butt, right to here. Spiral into his butt. Spiral back to his butt. Spiral back to his butt. Spiral, and in a match, I'm going to get all my weight on him. So as he gets back to his base, I'm going to be stuffing that head and getting all my weight on his head. Any questions on that little spiral floating drill?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you don't get it? All right. I'm in referee position. I like to throw a hat and open out with my right arm. So, my left arm is going to come inside the thigh. I'm going to jump to the opposite side, and when I do, my elbow is going to pull him to his butt, and I'm going to get all my weight on him. Then I'm going to take this arm and smash his head, put a half Nelson on nice and tight. Alright? That's all I'm doing. Alright? Any other questions? Hey, spiral your partner, go. So, I spiral ride a guy back, I punch that head, I get up upside on my toes, get every ounce of my weight on his neck. The reason I'm putting every ounce of my weight on his neck is because I am committing myself to turning him. I am not putting a half Nelson staying back here to make it look like I'm trying to make puppies or something. All right? That's not my goal. And girl, here to the side, every ounce of my weight on his head. Now here, if he tries to lift his head up, it's very hard for him to do. But if I am here, you know, this is called a basketball hat. Follow 12. So as he follows 12 and he's right here, this is what happens. Guys will always go, oh, but Corte couldn't hold his neck, it's too strong. Shut up! So once you get that hat, get up and sign up on your toes, you're gonna scare him with your hooves. All right? Right now, as I drive, push the head, he's scared. Right now, he's scared to death. He's sitting there going, holy shit, see Lopez monster. All right? Now, my job is not to attack him. So I come in here, I'm like, rah, and I'm like, right? Left elbow controls the hip. I do not have my left elbow at his flat. I have it at his hip. Not his flat, at his hip, but I do have the one-on-one wrist. Well, as I start to drive right here and I scare him, I see that far shoulder go down. Left elbow is going to hold his hip in the air. My right hip is going to trap his right elbow, and I am going to slightly put my right hip down on the mat, just like it is. Now right here, can you go anywhere, see? Alright? Now, if you notice, stay right in that position. Right in here, everybody in the place can see that he is pinned. I'm not putting him on his back. I'm not putting my weight on top of him and trying to lift him up. Go. Coach, I can't stack him. It's too fat. No, that's your fat ass. On top of his fat ass. Okay? So what we need to do when we're in here, get out to the side, elbow to the hip, drive. All right, you make way for the dentist. See? Right. No, you don't want that joke in there. Right hip on the elbow, and he's stuck like Chuck. Now, when I say the right hip on the right elbow, right elbow, this is the right hip. What happens is a lot of guys do just the opposite. They get this hat, elbow to the hip, they start to drive, and then they turn their other right hip now, which I call the left hip, and then I'm trying to pick the guy up now. And they can't stack. So if you want to stack them, right hip down, nice and easy. Now if I go chest to chest, what happens is, this guy's gonna try and rear. The referee has to get down on the mat and sit there and go, no, he's not pinned yet, he's not pinned. This team's over here yelling and screaming, he's pinned, he's pinned. This team's over here screaming and yelling, he's not. Meanwhile, you're putting pressure on the referee. That is rude. Referees, if you notice, a lot of them, you know, they're retired. You know, back then we used to cut weight, so maybe we'd have a big little belly there, you know. Walk around, they like to go around. Yeah, that doesn't stop, does it? All right? They don't want to have to get down on the mat, because if they do, then they got to get back up. All right? Are there any questions? How to spiral right, smash that head. Get that one around the wrist, hip to the elbow. Out by the side, scare them. All right? As you drive, circle around. Right hip down, elbow and a hip. The finish. Left knee, accidentally on purpose. Don't do it on purpose.
It's rude.
Accidentally on purpose, in the top of the head. Not in the face. Top of the head. What that does, if I take my knee and put it in the top of the head, it gets his chin into his chest. He's upside down. It's hard enough for him to, you know, breathe. He can breathe, but it makes it a lot harder for him to get that oxygen in. So, as I drive right here, accidentally on purpose. Now, am I allowed to kick the guy in the top of the head? Where is the referee going to be? Can he see me kick him in the top of the head? Now, I would have won the money once just to get the chin stuck in his chest. I don't sit there and pepper him 25 times, because the referee will be on the other side seeing him doing the funky chicken. And I'll splash me and say, whoa, what's going on? All right? Are there any questions on a spiral riding stack partner at 11 o'clock? Yes, sir.
George.
Sure.
George, two for two questions.
I spiral ride up to his butt, he gets up to his face, I get up on my toes, get the one-on-one wrist. As I start to drive, elbows to the hip, I circle the right hip down to trap, left knee accidentally on purpose, and my elbow is holding him in a stacked position, just like it at. Now sometimes I might take this, like this, and you're like, ah. You know, he's upside down staring at it. It sounds like he's choking on it. We know it's not that big. Okay. Are there any questions? Let's make your partner stump like Chuck. Let's do it. Understand, you don't have to spiral ride. Right off that whistle, once you get really comfortable with it, you can just jump up and put that hat on there. The key is, if you're on his neck, you're going to wear him out fast. Now, once I get this one-on-one wrist, right here, I'm going to pull his hand back so it almost like he can put his hand in his pocket so he can find a corner and call somebody who cares. Then I'm going to get the hook. Inside elbow to inside elbow. What I am going to do is I am going to make believe that these five fingers are American armies, and they are going to report to General Mills for their mission. What's our mission? Kill commie elbow. When I used to wrestle, it wasn't Al-Qaeda, it was a communist. We didn't like the commies. We used to say, kill commie for your mommy, and did a good deed for the day. That's why I always wanted to wrestle Russians, you know, kick the crap out of myself. So I make believe that this right elbow is the commie elbow. And just so you know, it wasn't the Russian wrestlers, they were great. It was their government, all right? So, these five American armies are like, General Mills, what's our vision? Kill commie elbow. Okay, boys. Now, these five American armies, as I drive, are going to parachute down. They don't want to parachute down until they have backup. So I send in the tank. Right now, he's staring down the barrel. Then I'm going to trap the Russian elbow with the right hip. Accidentally on purpose. Oh, sorry about that. And I sneak up and get it from the elbow. Just getting lazy. All right. Next step. One side back, just have no one in here. Only weight on his neck, grabbing one on the wrist, pull it back, so I can get the hook. Now, when I am hooking, I go inside elbow to inside elbow. Make sure it's nice and close. Go away. Very, very tight. I cannot see the nip of his swing an armbar and I am on the same side as an armbar, I do want to see the nip of the elbow. Because I take the nip of that elbow, I put it in the center of my sternum. I take this elbow and drive it up through his shoulder, through his ear, through his skull, through the man. But that's if I'm doing an armbar. I'm not doing an armbar. I'm doing a half Nelson with an armbar, not an armbar with a half Nelson. So if I have the half Nelson first, I get all my weight up here, elbow to elbow, pull it back, get the hook, and I bury my hand underneath. I try to flex my bicep, boom, right here, to stop that elbow from popping out. If the elbow pops out, you can still pin the guy and it will still be tight. But one thing I used to do is I would like to make all my moves what they call holy shit tight. So the only thing going through his mind is holy shit, freaking call it. Right? They don't want to be there. But if you let the elbow come out, think about this. If you got put on your back, what would you try to do? What would you try to do? That's what you want to do, all right? So, once I've got this half Nelson in here, I get that elbow deep, right through here. Now, as I drive him, I keep my hips low. By putting my hips low, it's like I'm stretching everything right here. Like, ah. Is that uncomfortable when I do that?
Yes.
All right? When I'm driving right here, it's really stretching all that. Right through here, bar shoulders down, hands shoulders down.
Questions tonight, I'll help you guys out. So,
what?
Okay. I did not start wrestling until I was a freshman in high school. I was a fat little 88-pound butterball, wrestling 98 varsity, and a lot of times when I would go to turn somebody, they would post off that left leg and make it really hard for me to turn. And being my first year, I wasn't sure what the heck to do, but I figured it out. So, I get this half Nelson up. Guys would post off that left leg. And I couldn't get him to go anywhere. So what I figured out is if he posts that left leg out there, I am going to turn my palm back and up. I am not going to reach in this way and have him kick his leg back and have the Rice Krispie elbow. All right? I don't want to hear a snap, crackle, pop. So I want to turn my palm back and up. Now, by my sophomore year in high school, at one point I was 19-0 with 19 pins. And a lot of times if a guy would post off that left leg, this is what I would do. Get in here, I turn my palm inside the thigh, and I would go, okay, Gene, bring it up, okay, Gene, bring it over, okay. And I would pin the guy. Well, after doing that a bunch of times, I had a few referees go off on me. And they're like, Gene, what the hell are you doing? I go, what do you mean, what am I doing? I'm playing confidence. I go, I'm sitting there, I've got this half Nelson on, he's posting off that left leg, I'm making him lean on the crane, right? This is the crane, I'm the crane operator. And I go, okay, Jane, bring it up, okay, bring it up, okay. And I pin the guy. Now, the referees, you know, after the match, try to sit down and say, you gotta understand something, if it doesn't work, you're gonna look stupid. I'm like, excuse me? He goes, if it doesn't work, you're gonna look stupid. I'm like, what do you mean not work? This move is infallible. He is posting off that left leg. I am blocking his right thigh with my left knee, and I am pulling him in the way he is driving. How can that not work? If it doesn't work, you're gonna look stupid. So, plan B. I have Nelson on here, all right? He's posting off that left leg, and I go, okay, Gene, bring it up. Okay, Gene, bring it up. Okay, Gene, bring it up. Shit, if that don't work, all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab a hold of that stick shift and shift gears. I'm only kidding. Not allowed to grab the first picture. Right? Yeah, leave that thing alone. Headlocks illegal. Arm locks illegal. Pull locks are illegal. All right. Not allowed to knock that pole deep at all. So once I have the half Nelson, ladies, he posts off that left leg. I turn that palm back and up. I'm like, okay, can you bring it up? When all I'm doing is I'm dropping to my knees and I am pulling him off his base. My elbow is pulling him off his base, and it looks like I am picking this leg up. But actually, it's just the opposite. I'm pulling him over. Then I'm going, oh, no, bring it over. Bring this leg over. But what I am actually doing is I am pivoting off the instep of my left foot, pivoting my knee up to help lift his butt up in the air, and then I am going to take him over to stack him nice and neatly on his shoulder blades, right here. And then it's pinned. Now, that is called the half crane, all right? Are there any questions on a half crane? If the guy posts off the left leg, he will also be clamping down. So bottom guy, you need to be a good partner. Start taking them at that direction and their arm starts going over their head and you start hearing, ah! Well, first of all, bottom guy, pull your elbow in. All right, top guy, be careful. And if he doesn't, just tell him, remind him. Pull that elbow in like you wouldn't imagine. Sometimes, you know, the pressure's not on you. You know, you're not gonna clamp down because you're trying to help him learn to move, which is a good thing. But give honest reaction, not resistance, reaction so they could actually learn. Are there any questions? Yes, sir.
What are you doing with your legs? Are you blocking?
I am actually blocking his knee and I'm pulling. And then I'm pushing up this foot and I am posting on my head and I'm rotating this knee up as I'm picking him up. So I pick the hip up and circle and post on my head. I'll show you one more time. If he's posting off that left leg, post off his left leg, I drop my knees, I pull him over, and then I go near shoulder, and then stack in the far shoulder. If he kicks his legs back, I can always pull this far arm right to here and settle it just like it is. All right? Now, I want to make sure that I am pinning him in this stacked position. Now, I went to high school in Jersey, and, you know, in high school, I remember I had five tournaments. Christmas tournament, counties, districts, regions, states, and I pinned guys in the finals. And pretty much every time, I had like this. Finals at national, same thing, NCAA, the Tbilisi tournament over in Russia, the World Super Championships. The guys are the first, second, third, and fourth in the Olympics. All of them, their feet were way up in the air. I didn't give them an opportunity to be on their backs so they could bridge because I had things to do. So, you know, what am I going to hang out all day to freaking beat the guy by punch or something? No. Question? No? Speak up and stack your partner. Go. Because if they post off the left leg, you'll see why. But 20, 30 years ago, I used to go to Pee Wee tournaments, and I would do clinics after weigh-ins, so that way the people that are running the tournament focus on getting the brackets and stuff done, and not have 500 to 700 kids running around like idiots destroying their building. So I would do little clinics, and I'd do like little half-hour clinics or whatever. And this move, twice I had kids come up to me and say, Coach, I really like this move, and I'm going to try it today. Well, the one guy had 5 matches, the other guy had 7 matches. They had pinned everybody they had wrestled, and they both ended up being state champs. And one guy ended up winning as a freshman. But it's called a half cradle, all right? And this is great for some of you guys. I know, you know, a lot of kids are dyslexic. Some guys have ADD, you know, some people have ADHD, and some people are ADAD, you know? And this is great. What? You don't know what ADAD means? As dumb as dirt. So for those guys, it's great too. You get confused, you don't know what to do to have to do the bailing. Screw it, you're both at the same time. Alright? So I've got the half, he posts off that left leg. What I do is I guide this arm and I run the head to the knee and reach around and hook the bicep. I do not grab it, so it's a pull forward. I hook it. Now, I said I like to do it on the guys that had big arms, so make it like he's got big arms. Alright? And what I do is I go, oh, geez. You're my hero. Now, they would always clamp with their right arm, and as I do, I would pull them into that stacked position. Now, right here, can you go anywhere, Steve? If I kick my feet back, does this make it tighter?